So let's talk a little bit about graft versus host disease. That's one of our wild cards with transplant, because we can't look at an individual and say, well, you're a male, you're this old, you have this kind of donor, and this is your match grade. This is how much GVHD you are going to have. Unfortunately, we don't know that. So this is something we monitor for very closely after transplant. So the goal of transplant is something called graft versus tumor or graft versus leukemia effect. The graft is your donor, okay? You are the host. So the way I like to think about graft versus host disease is I like to think of your bone marrow space as an apartment. Well, what are we doing to that apartment? We're taking chemotherapy, radiation sometimes, and we're evicting your current renter. We're saying, bye-bye, you're not a good renter, you're making a mess, you're not paying rent, I want you out. So we're taking that chemotherapy regimen and we're evicting the host. That's what we want, right? We then move in the graft. The graft is your new renter, and we're hoping they're going to be more responsible. As the graft is unpacking in their new home, their job is to detect all the little cockroaches and dust mites and things that the host left behind and squash them. That's your disease. And it's disease that sometimes, although we have great measures, we can't detect. So healthy immune systems every day fight off offenses, they fight off mutations. People who are coming to stem cell transplant no longer have the ability to do that. So we evict their renter, we move in the new one, okay? So new renter's in there and they're killing the cockroaches and dust mites. That is graft versus tumor or graft versus leukemia. That is the desired effect from transplant. The flip side to that is one of those complications that we're constantly going to monitor for after transplant, and that is graft versus host disease. So as those graft cells or the new renters unpacking and making space to make new functional cells for you, they look around and say, I don't like the window treatments this guy left behind. That can be anything. Those window treatments they don't like can be your skin, your gut, your eyes, any other organ system in your body. What we're changing in you is your DNA. All your tissue cells are what you were born with. So the graft comes in, they realize they don't like it, and they mount an attack, and your body has a response to that. And so we're going to talk about those cases, because we can have acute forms of this and we can have chronic forms of this, but essentially it's your graft, your donor, not getting along with your host cells. A lot of people sometimes confuse this with you are rejecting the cells, and that's not quite what's happening. So let's talk a little bit more. So the first type that we're going to talk about is acute graft versus host disease. You'll see on the slide deck as you're going through these with me, pages listed as 57 through 60. When you as the patient or your loved one first came to meet us here at the Colorado Blood Cancer Institute, their transplant coordinator, somebody like me, handed them a white binder that is specific to allogeneic transplant. So when I talk about page numbers, those are the pages I'm referring to, and they'll give you more details as we go through this overview. So acute graft versus host disease, discussed more in detail on pages 57 through 60. And this is thought to occur within the first 100 days post-transplant. So it's acute, or what we consider early graft versus host disease. The most common sites for this to happen are going to be the skin, the GI tract, and the liver. And people often wonder, well, how do you monitor for those? We do visual assessments of your skin, we're monitoring your labs, and we're depending on the patient and their caregiver to report any symptoms that are coming up so we can help figure out what might be causing those. So we do assess this regularly. One important thing that we always say a patient can do to help prevent this or control it is to take medications as instructed and report your symptoms promptly. So as Callie said much earlier, when we pick those transplant regimens for you, every regimen comes with an immunosuppressant plan, because we have to find a way to keep your cells, both yours and your donors, getting along until the donor can take over and we know that they're getting along happily. So how can you help control this is by taking those medications as instructed. And that means if you come out and you're taking that tacrolimus medication or sirolimus medication, and the prescription is for twice a day, that means 6 a.m., 6 p.m. 9 a.m., 9 p.m. Whatever you decide, we want you spacing that appropriately so that if you're not taking one when you wake up and one at lunch. We want your body to have a consistent level of those medications so we can help control this if possible. The big important thing on this slide, and you're going to see it on several slides, is it says, please call with any symptoms that occur between visits. And we can't stress that enough. Yes, we're seeing you twice a week, but if you came in Monday evening at 4 o'clock for an appointment, and your next appointment is Thursday at 8 a.m., and Wednesday night you notice a rash, and you think, I'm not going to call, it's no big deal, no one needs to know what's happening, we do want to know. We want you to give us a call and let us know when the rash showed up, what it looked like, if anything makes it better or worse, so that when we assess it the next morning, we know if it looks better or worse and we can tell how to treat it. So please don't hesitate to call us in between your visits. Let's talk a little bit about chronic graft versus host disease. In those white binders, they're in the pages that follow on pages 61 and 62. This is thought to usually occur after the first 100 days, but we're learning over time that this can present a little earlier, but it's chronic because it lasts longer. So we think of chronic graft versus host disease like a chronic condition, and the acute, if it helps you remember it, you think of it like a flare-up, something that pops up, we try to treat it, it goes away. Chronic has more long-lasting effects, and it's more of a nuisance for longer. So we have to try to keep a tighter lid on it if we can. The more common sites for this is skin thickening. People notice coloration changes to their skin. Their skin can get dry and flaky. So when we're talking about skin, liver, gut, and some of the systems it can affect, that's something that can happen to the skin. People notice they get just a dry cough. Always dry cough, their eyes get scratchy, some blurry vision. People can have abdominal cramping or long-lasting GI issues, aching joints, muscles, tight joints you'll notice. When you come in, I can't do it right now because I'm obviously injured, but we make you take your hands and put them like this and spread your elbows out. Over time, we see if you're still able to do that and how the chronic forms of graft versus host disease may be affecting your joints. So keep that in mind when we ask you to do weird things. It's because we're assessing what potentially could happen after your transplant. And again, call between visits with any symptoms because we need to know what's going on. So let's talk a little bit about outpatient precautions. Precautions are a big thing in everyday life. And for cancer patients and more specifically bone marrow transplant patients, we like to be extra cautious with how we live out our daily life to help protect us, okay?